This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com, and today I'm here to talk to you about living in parallel quantum worlds. The idea for today's discussion came to me when I was reading a recent issue from, well actually it's last year, from Scientific American, and this one's all about, as it says, living in a quantum world. Small-scale physics has a spooky power over the world at large. What really thrilled me about finding this particular magazine with this particular topic, and you can find this online, is that basically it's saying something that I haven't really seen in mainstream scientific publications until now, and that is that a lot of the characteristic behavior of quantum particles that we normally expect to see in the realm of the very, very small, is now being observed in things like plants, animals, and salt crystals. And these recent pieces of scientific experimental evidence of what we would normally call quantum entanglement, we'll still call it that for want of a better term, but it's happening at larger and larger scales of entities, whether it's a plant, an animal, or a salt crystal. And the thing that's so exciting to me about that is that we're starting to get a glimpse of the concept that a lot of the things we'd expect to see, such as quantum entanglement, quantum teleportation, and there's the teleportation, the tunneling, and the entanglement. These sorts of things that you see on the very, very small scale, normally you wouldn't expect to see it on the large scale. However, probabilistically, we should expect to see it, and we actually indeed are. So that's a little bit of the science behind all of this. There's something else exciting about this entire topic for me, and that is, of course, that I love to hear the experiential side of it as well. And this month, I got the chance to read a lovely book called Traveling to Parallel Universes. This book is written by Trish Lesage, and it's a picture of her on the back of the book. And this is an extraordinary book because it's the first one that I've really seen talking from a first-hand account about the sorts of things that I often call reality shifts, but from the perspective of someone who actually recognizes that she is traveling between parallel realities, parallel universes. I'm just going to read a short excerpt from her fantastic book, and here she says, "It can become a bit confusing, however, when the differences in the details are more apparent from one universe to another. For example, restaurants that were closed in one universe are open in another." Trish also notices lots of differences in the animals, the wild animals that she experiences on a regular basis in her life. Sometimes in one universe they're there, in another they're gone. Sometimes personalities change of both people and animals. So I highly recommend this book for anyone interested in what I call reality shifts, but also basically evidence of traveling to parallel universes. And of course, another book that I always would recommend if you're interested in this subject would be Reality Shifts, When Consciousness Changes the Physical World. And I also write about what it feels like to, as I call it, live with feet in both worlds. And here, toward the end of the book, I'm writing, "Living with the waking dream experience of reality shifting around me feels a lot like walking with my feet in two or more worlds. Since I've acknowledged reality shifts, my life has continued to be much the same in most respects. I still sleep at night and go about my regular daily activities. I still need the simple, basic necessities I always did, and I still occasionally feel burning desires to see an exhilarating movie, go for long walks, read good books, or eat delicious meals." And then I continue and say, "By welcoming a waking dream state of consciousness, I allow for the unexpected to occur. Even ordinary things like cooking dinner have a different feeling for me. Sometimes I've opened my refrigerator to get something, shut the door, opened it again a few minutes later, and found a jar had vanished and reappeared in that short space of time." And that really gives you a sense of how I feel about reality shifts and traveling between parallel universes. But I'd like you to start thinking about it as well, and recognizing that this is the sort of thing that could be happening all the time. We're getting a lot more of a hint from current studies in science, such as the ones I mentioned earlier this year about entangled diamonds and altruistic rats. And when you consider that we're getting all of these indicators that are showing us this is what it might look like when you do travel between parallel universes. You might not notice that the whole universe is different. You might just see one or two small things that are different. And you can sometimes go back and forth between them. So, with all of that in mind, I'd like to ask my favorite question for you to keep in mind as well. And that is, how good can it get when you travel between parallel realities? So until next time, this is Cynthia Sue Larson with RealityShifters.com.